So, welcome to the Sifu Sergio video. We're here in Beijing, and this is the school of Sifu Wong Qipeng. And yeah, it's going to be an interview, and we're going to ask if we can film some practical things also for some further videos. And yeah, very excited. It's a Sifu that I respect very much, especially for his practical fighting skill. So yeah, let's go inside. So, Sifu, can you tell us a bit about your martial art background?
Because I was born in Neimeng Gu, in the south of China, Because I was very interested in the movies and the novels, and I was very interested in the martial arts. I was very interested in the martial arts. My uncle was a teacher of the Yi Ke Zhao Meng Wu 然后他会教我一些简单的一些功夫，所以说我就比较喜欢这种功夫，从小就练习跟他们跟一些叔叔跟一些舅舅练习功夫，很基本的踢腿啊、翻跟头啊、柔韧性啊、协调性啊，练习这个。后来呢长大一点了，十几岁就出来了，大概是十二岁那年就出来了，我就去了那个河南，去河南少林寺去学功夫，去学少林拳，去学硬气功。你是硬气功呢，还有学硬气功跟散打，还有少林的功夫，然后每天练得很辛苦，然后很小嘛，每天去拍那个什么沙袋，练你的掌的硬度、拳的硬度、肘的硬度、膝的硬度、头的硬度，啊，我觉得当时想的很天真，觉得练功夫呢，我看人家表演拿砖头，很容易就把那个砖头削掉。我认为如果我练得很好的话，削砖头这么容易，那人脑袋很容易啪上去一下，哇，碎了，这是应该是最棒的功夫啊，因为他们表演拿着砖头这么一捏就碎掉了，一打就碎了，很容易用任何身体任何一部位都可以把砖打碎啊。但是慢慢的学着学着觉得大一点就知道了，学了几个月发现就是功夫不应该是这样子的啊，因为我后来发现那个他们有师兄弟去对打，就是俩人打很容易就打晕了，那他的硬度就不见了，他练的硬气功练的这个不怕打的功夫在实战中还是没有用的，他练铁拳功呢练的能打碎砖头，但是人脑袋还在打，人的脑袋是还是打不碎的，我就觉得很疑惑，为什么打砖头那么厉害，打人反而打不了，我就后来发现打